In the last segment, Yankin gave a perspective of how automotive chip designs are evolving and what we can expect in the next few years. In this segment, we're going to focus on the impact safety requirements have on automotive SoC design. You have all this complexity of the vehicle needing to visualize the environment in real time and then take appropriate action. But then again, the underlying hardware and software for this must also be built for functional safety, as you said, to minimize the risk of a catastrophic failure as defined by the ISO 262 standard. So what impact do these safety requirements have on processor architectures?
Yeah, Matt, if you are designing automotive systems, first of all, today, even without any of that computing, they have to be certified. They have to be safety certified in some level of ASIL, depending, again, it is relevance. Nevertheless, more and more compute power is getting into the car. That means the chips, the system on chips in the car have to be certified as well. And in many, many of the cases, even the IP blocks within those SoCs, these building blocks, and especially the processor IP have to be certified. In automotive applications, we are seeing today more integration of discrete devices into single multifunctional integrated circuits.
Right.
And as an example, instead of a separate chip responsible for device safety management sitting next to the ADAS chip, you will have now that safety component sitting into the same ADAS chip. In some cases, you will try to achieve that safety with redundancy of those ADAS chip. In some cases, you will do that redundancy of functionality. This simplifies both hardware and software integration. Having both safety critical and mission mode applications running on a single chip. And this all again makes it easier to verify and certify compared to when this functionality was spread potentially over the board or even within the car in different ECUs. And even if you look at the processor IP block itself, we are adding today dedicated hardware safety features as well as a complete set of safety manuals and reports that our customers need to certify their products. So our offering is becoming more and more complete, whereas you have a certified IP block and we are augmenting that whole block with additional documentation and everything you need to certify your whole chip.
Be sure to watch the final segment to learn the role of a safety manager on a chip, as well as how security is being addressed in automotive SoC design.